I'm here sure is quiet. That's not the worst, I guess. Hephaestus whining, Athena and Aphrodite. Bickering? Ares losing his cool? Let me know if you're in the market for anything.
Are you in the market to buy?
Ah! Fenyx stumbled upon a winged creature. As Fenyx freed the small creature imprisoned on the isle, she let out a cry, which meant, "Great hero, I am but a piece of Nike, the goddess of victory. Please free the others, so I may return to my full glory."
They won't win without Nike. She's like a glove or a thing you wear that protects you while running. A helmet. So, what is it?
Fenyx would need to free it to find out.
Yeah, but you can tell me now.
Can you please respect my narrative pacing? Valley of Eternal Spring. Its highlights include a massive tree that reaches up to the heavens. The Hall of the Gods. Eros's Palace.
Oh, I'm glad he finally got his happy ending.
And a palace belonging to the Goddess of Beauty herself.
Of course Aphrodite would claim the prime real estate with the best view. As long as she's safe from prying eyes, I'm happy.
From such great heights, a flood Fenyx's eye.
Fenyx was about as high as I was when I thought marrying Aphrodite off to Hephaestus would stop the other gods from fighting over her.
Yes, that view from Mount Olympus is something else. I haven't seen it in years.
You're not getting that high again, so stop asking!